having my morning coffee, seeing my neighbor's car shot up.
For Michael Hartung, violence has never been closer to home.
He's like, well, the guy was standing right in front of your house, shooting down that way.
Police say audio captured more than a dozen gunshots at last night's shooting scene. One man was hit in the head, another in the leg, just a few houses down from Hartung. It's the latest in a series of daily shootings Chief Harto says stem from a variety of factors.
Some do have gang connotations, others are just arguments and fights, domestics.
Chief Harto says none of the recent cases are related. Balloons and flowers mark the location of a homicide Tuesday at Knox Avenue North and 26th Avenue North. The medical examiner says a 17-year-old boy was shot in the head.
That's just crazy.
Rachel Edlund is raising three children in a home a block from last night's shooting.
You know, I just want to keep my kids safe. You should be able to be safe in your own home, you know, inside and outside of the home.
Police say they're being proactive. They seized 26 guns in the past week. The guns were either stolen, used in a crime, or in the hands of a convicted felon. And many of the arrests they've made have been repeat offenders.
So the question is, why are we arresting the same people? Why are they out allowed to reoffend? They will either be our next homicide suspect or our next homicide victim.
And police say with six shooting victims this past week, they've not arrested any of the shooters in those cases. They tell me they expect to make a few of those arrests in the coming days. Randy.
All right. Thank you, Ivory. And